Hello, wonderful person, this is Anton, and about a year ago, or I guess almost exactly a year ago, this happened. This was the most streamed video on YouTube, and was probably one of the coolest achievements of the human race for the past few decades. It definitely created a lot of excitement, it definitely created a lot of controversy, but I think most of us really loved the event. This was when Elon Musk decided to launch his own Tesla Roadster on top of a Falcon Heavy rocket. And as you can probably tell from the title, today we're going to find out where it's actually most likely located right now, a year later after the launch. So to do this, we're actually going to be using Universe Sandbox Square, the simulation I often use on the channel. And in that simulation, we can actually trace the approximate location of the vehicle using our current understanding of the trajectory. Now, unfortunately, it's not 100% accurate, but for the most part, it's going to be accurate enough. Also, we're probably not going to actually see or hear or even detect this particular vehicle for at least, I guess, 50 years. Possibly more, and you'll see why. So first of all, before I show it to you, take a guess, where do you think it is in relation to other planets, in relation to our own planet, just in general, where do you think it is after about a year? Now, the common misconception is to assume that it's actually going to be in the same location where it launched from, in other words, where Earth would be. And the reality is a little bit more complex than that. The reality is that it's actually not in that location. So here we are. What we're going to do is we're going to advance the date a little bit because I did start the simulation a little bit earlier than February 7th. And we're going to go to February 7th to see where this beautiful vehicle that you can see right here on the screen ends up after, I guess, 2 weeks of game time. So it most likely still looks about the same. It may have lost a little bit of paint. It may also have lost a little bit of the rubber part of the wheel. Most of it is because it's basically been bombarded by solar radiation. And a lot of this radiation is slowly going to, strip the car piece by piece. And within about a million years, there actually might be almost nothing left here. Except for maybe some metal parts. The metal parts will be really hard to strip. So, okay, so this is February 4th, and right now on February 7th, I'm going to go for February 7th around 5 a.m. in the morning, although I think it happened a little bit later than that. The actual launch was a little bit later. The vehicle is going to be in the following location. So, we're going to zoom out here, and in a few seconds, you're going to see where it is approximately. So here we go. So it is in a location a little bit past the orbit of Mars, possibly somewhat close to the actual asteroid belt, although not quite there. And if I enable the orbits here, you'll see that its orbit is quite peculiar. So it sort of is on the way back to the Earth orbit, although it already passed its so-called apoapsis, or the highest point of its orbit. In terms of the actual orbital parameters, its total one single orbit takes approximately 1.53 years. So almost just over 1 year and a half. It also has a somewhat inclined orbit, so it's not exactly in the same plane as, say, Earth, and it's a little bit closer to Mars, but even more inclined than Martian orbit. So for this particular car to somehow cross Mars is going to be very difficult. It's probably never actually going to happen. The closest approach here is still pretty far. It will eventually return to the same location around Earth, but it will actually take many decades, possibly over 100 years, for us to actually finally intercept it in the same location where it was launched. So there might be a chance that maybe in the next few decades it actually will come much closer to Earth than it is right now. However, it's not going to come close enough for us to capture it or to even see it. As a matter of fact, there's a website where you can try to trace the possible orbital intercepts, and I'm posting this link in the description below, but here is what the closest approaches are going to be in the next, approximately 150 years. And the reason I chose 150 years is because I think most of us most likely will not be around to see everything after that. So one of the closest first approaches is actually going to happen right here. This is in 2021, and it's going to be about 0.28 astronomical units away from Earth. And that, of course, means 0.28 or 28% of the distance of Earth to the Sun. Actually, I should have done this in kilometers. And that's actually approximately 42 million kilometers, which is really, really far. The next relatively close approach is going to be right here, 10 million kilometers in 2048. And then we have another approach, 2050 at 22 million kilometers. And as you can actually see, there's not going to be that many close approaches. The distance of the Moon to Earth is just over 300,000 kilometers, so nothing as close to the Moon. As a matter of fact, there's going to be almost nothing for the next few hundred years, at least using the current parameters. Now, you can actually try this yourself. I provided the link for this simulation in the description, but here, let's just do 2800 and do the same thing, plot this, and see if anything appears. And okay, there's something 2-3 million kilometers. That's still far. So nothing below 1 million kilometers. So it's very likely that unless we go and try to capture the beautiful Tesla Roadster manually and we actually launch some kind of intercept mission, we're not really going to see it in the vicinity of Earth for the next several hundred years. Oh, and by the way, if you don't have Universe Sandbox and you don't want to purchase it for one reason or another, which is understandable because, you know, it's money, maybe, just maybe, you can actually use the website I just used to try to locate this yourself. And so what you do is you go to the website I posted in the link in the description below, and then you'll get something that looks like this, that shows you a relatively accurate representation of the solar system with the Roadster right there, still in orbit, still doing its own thing, which is nothing, just sitting there. Now, it would actually be very interesting to try to possibly send a mission to just kind of see what's happened to the Roadster in 2021, because we are capable of launching something that will intercept this craft. But it's going to be an expensive mission and most likely will require another Falcon Heavy rocket to actually try to launch a mission that can take photos and possibly take a video of this particular event. And there's definitely a lot of scientific things we can discover here if we are able to actually go there in 2021. However, there's no such mission planned, and the only way we can plan it is to maybe somehow encourage Elon Musk to do another crazy mission and to try to maybe forget about Mars for now and just send a mission to his own car and do a service or something, or possibly have it refueled, or maybe even capture it and bring it back to Earth, just to see if we can actually essentially create the most impressive commercial for Tesla. A car that can go to space, return, and still work just fine. If that doesn't make you buy a Tesla, I don't know what will. And anyway, that's all I wanted to do in this particular video. I wanted to briefly show you where Roadster is right now and how you can discover and even track it yourself. Most importantly, I'm hoping that one day maybe Elon Musk will see this video and consider the mission 2021 to look at what happened to his car and maybe just maybe bring it back. I mean, that's just a cool idea, isn't it? Anyway, on this note, thank you for watching. Come back tomorrow to learn something else. Subscribe if you still haven't. And share this video with someone who enjoys watching space videos and wants to know more about sciences in space. I'll see you tomorrow. Space out, and as always, bye-bye. And maybe even consider supporting this channel on Patreon, because it does help me a lot. This is my primary job now, so I basically depend on whatever I make on YouTube. Bye-bye.